Havval Ismail. Havval says in his question, Islam is mixed with my blood, but it is about a month. An evil idea has come to my mind and whispers to me that Allah does not exist and Quran is not sent down by Allah, and tells me that the Quran is only magic and I don't want to lose my beautiful religion. First of all, Havval, I would like to assure you that you are a believer. Alhamdulillah, shukla. So what about those thoughts and how did you judge him as a believer? Because look what he said. He said an evil idea. So he recognizes that as an evil idea and he's very certain and he's fully aware as nothing but the whispers of Satan. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned his companions that Satan may whisper to them about Allah himself and whether he really exists or not and how he was created and who created him. He warned against that. And he said, when you come to this level, then think only about the creation and the qualities of Allah, not about the being of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani, normally when we get involved in debates with atheists who are basically believers in this condition which you describe it as an evil idea, they say there is no God and they are very agnostic and there is no Quran, there are no prophets. Well, if there is no God, then everything was created haphazardly and basically by mere chance. They try to forge some theories in order to, you know, justify their misbelief. Well, here we begin by addressing this matter logically and also scientifically. Then we refer to Quranic verses which support that in order to establish the proof. So what do we use in that? We use the Quranic methodology of proving the presence of God. Then we use the Quranic methodology in proving the oneness of the Lord. Then we use the Quranic methodology in proving via logic that God exists and He is the only one who is worthy of worship and we should fulfill our duties to Him. Then we also, via logic, prove what the Quran proved, that there will be a resurrection after death. And that is called belief in monotheism. العلم نور. Knowledge is light. Knowledge takes people from darkness into light. It's a lot easier for Satan to take down a worshipper, a person who has a huge prayer mark or prayer on his forehead, and a woman who's constantly in worship but without knowledge. Knowledge is a shield, is a fortress that protects a person against the deviant ideas, the deviant parties, and the whispers of a shaitan. Imagine when one of the very righteous people saw a huge being sitting on a throne between the heavens and the earth, blocking the horizon. And he said to him, Ya Abd al-Qadir, I am your Lord. I want you to put yourself in his position and see in this huge thing, which you don't know what is it, but it fills the whole view, the whole horizon. And he talks to you and says, I'm your Lord, very happy with you, I love you, and I waived the mandate of the prayer for you. You don't have to pray anymore because I love you. The prayer is for the weak ones. So at that, this scholar, because he was a scholar, he said, Iqsa ya adu Allah, may you be disgraced, O the enemy of Allah. Then he sought refuge with Allah again as outcast Satan, and this creature disappeared. This creature disappeared. Why? Knowledge says Allah ordained the prayer even upon the prophets. Is there anyone who is dearer to Allah than the prophets? The answer is definitely none. There are some Sufi mystics who say there are some peers or some poles or some awliya who are dearer to Allah than even the prophets. And that is absolutely nullified and proven to be mere falsehood by the Quran. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَآلَ عِمْرَانَ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah chose Allah yastafi min al-malaikati rusulan wa min al-nas. He chooses and he chose already from the angels and from the human beings whom he likes, the elite, to send them with his message. So people to them are inferior to them. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the dearest and the most loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have many ayat and many hadith in this reference. Yet Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until the last breath, he was very keen to attend the prayer. And sometimes when he was in his death sickness, he ordered them to pour 7 water containers over him in order to cool off his fever. And he said, "Support me." And they supported him until he made it to the Qibla. Then afterward, he would pray while sitting down or while on his bed. He did not skip the prayer in any condition, not even on the battlefield. So that's an indication that if somebody is asking me to skip the prayer because he claims that he is God and he loves me, he must be a liar. Allah did not waive the mandate of the prayer for Prophet Muhammad or for any of the prophets. Okay. So basically what I'm trying to bring to your attention, brothers and sisters, is knowledge. Knowledge is the key. Those thoughts would never cross the mind of a true seeker of knowledge, because every day he's earning some useful knowledge. He's reading the Quran. A Meccan pagan who happened to come to Al-Madina, and he was either among the prisoners of war or came to free a prisoner of war, Al-Mut'am ibn Adi. He heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting in the Maghrib prayer of Surah At-Tur. Then he came across number 35 and 36. And this guy was a disbeliever. He believes in idols. He doesn't believe in Allah. He doesn't believe in Muhammad. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happened to recite the following ayah. And he says, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. These two ayat made this guy say, فَكَادَ قَلْبِي أَنْ يَطِيرُ. My heart was about to fly. It shocked him. These rhetorical questions, were they created without anything, without a creator, or have they created themselves? The same questions we keep proposing to those who didn't believe in God. Who created you? Well, according to the law of cause and effect, every action must have a reaction. And everything happened must have a cause. And something led it to happen. So, who caused us to exist? And what is the reason behind our existence? The system, the galaxies and the stars floating in this orbit in a very accurate system. والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون. This ayat of Surah Yasin talking about the sun and the moon floating in their orbits in an accurate system. Not a single one overcome the other. No, everything is happening with an accurate measure until the day of judgment. Will these informations of the space, of the absent world, of the unseen to us being provided to us, then gradually over hundreds of years, now it's been more than 1400 years since the Quran was revealed, many truths being unfolded to confirm what the Quran has proven. When you read every night, when you get up to pray the tahajjud, the ayat which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended to be recited before the tahajjud, when you get up from your sleep, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. This conclusion by the end of the second ayah, ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا, our Lord. So they recognize that there is a creator and he is the Lord. You have not created all of that in vain. Rather, glory be to you, so protect us against the fire of hell. As a result of that, they believe that there is Allah and there is hereafter and there is punishment and reward. As a result of what? As a result of investigating and studying in this open universal book, indeed in the creation of the heavens and the earth and in the alternation of the day and the night. There are signs for people who reflect and ponder, for men of sanity, of aql, for those who ponder. When you just bother to take a look around you and reflect upon this open universal book in light with the ayat which talked about that, then you end up saying, Subhanak, praise and glory be to you. ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. So I advise you to increase your knowledge. Attend the Aqidah class. If you don't have the means, if you don't have a chance, if you don't have an available class or school nearby, you can download some classes of the Aqidah, especially belief in the Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Lordship and in the oneness of Allah and in the unity of His names and attributes. And examine the ayat and the hadith which talk about that. Then you will be a firm believer. I can assure you that non-Muslims are easy to convert because their belief is very vulnerable, very fragile. Yani, it is not based on sound proofs, and it is not compatible with logic. While the case is absolutely on the contrary when it comes to Islam, it makes all the sense, and all your questions are being answered. So I assure you, Alhamdulillah, you are a believer, but in order to maintain your belief, you need to take my previous advice.
Huda TV's social media sites are the best way to contact us from anywhere around the world. Stay connected with Huda TV's latest news and programs through Facebook, Twitter, Google+, YouTube, Skype, and Instagram. It's fast and easy. Stay up to date with your favorite shows and scholars today. Huda TV, a light in every home.